Hello everyone, I'm Chris with Toolbox DIY, and today I'm going to demystify all the technical jargon that you find on the back of an LED light. I'm going to cover everything you see on this label and give you some tips on choosing the right LED light. Let's get started with light output. On an LED label, you'll see something called lumens. This is the amount of output that a light produces. Now, you don't need to understand the science behind how lumens are measured. Just know that the higher number, the greater the output. So when two bulbs say that they're equivalent to a 60 watt incandescent, you can use the lumen number to figure out which one is going to be brighter or dimmer. Now, if the packaging doesn't include an equivalent to an incandescent bulb, you can refer to the reference table that I've included on the Toolbox DIY website to help you make that determination. The next thing you'll find is the estimated yearly energy cost. Now, if you don't know what your kilowatt hour energy cost is, I don't think that this number is very useful. I find it more helpful to go to search for an online LED savings calculator to determine how much money you will actually save given your circumstances. Moving down the label, we see the lifespan. I don't find this number very useful at all. I think it's rather misleading. It's a rather long explanation why I feel that way, but you can learn more about that in our video, Tips for Buying LED Lights. I really only use this number when all other things are equal and I am having a hard time making a decision. I might choose the one with the longer lifespan. Next up, we have the energy used. This is the amount of power that it takes to drive this particular light. What I actually find more useful is lumens per watt, because that tells you how efficient that this particular light is going to be. Some labels show that, this one does not. You can easily calculate it by dividing lumens by the watts, and that will give you the efficiency. All other things being equal, it's better to go with a higher efficiency because it's taking less power to produce the same amount of light. Another number you might see on a label is the color rendering index, or the CRI. Unfortunately, this is becoming less common, but I still think it's a rather important number. This light doesn't have it, nor do any of the other labels that I have, but you might find it on the larger lights like the PAR 38. What the CRI is it tells you how accurately colors look under this particular light. Now, some people don't think this is very important, but if you have a hard time distinguishing between, say, a black piece of clothing and a navy blue piece of clothing, a high CRI may be a better option for a closet or for a bedroom. Personally, I don't buy any lights that have a CRI under 90. Lastly, and most importantly in my opinion, is the color temperature. On this label, it's noted as light appearance. This is a four-digit number followed by K. The K is just Kelvin, which is a unit of measure of color temperature. What you need to know is that the lower the number, the more warm or orange the light will appear. The higher the number, the more cool or blue the light will appear. My recommendation is that bedrooms and bathrooms should get 2700 to 3000 K color temperature. Kitchens and utility rooms, I aim for 4000 to 4500. And in my garage and workshop, I go for 5000 or even higher. Just know that the higher the number, the more blue the light. If you put this in a bedroom, this could actually interfere with your circadian rhythm because blue light is telling your brain it's not time to go to bed. So you may want to consider the warmer or more orange lights for the bedroom. Of course, color temperature is a personal preference, so choose the color that works for you. Well, that covers all the technical information you need to know to help you choose the right LED light. Now, the label isn't the only factor in choosing a light. You may also care about the physical appearance of the light, how the lens looks, if the bulb is going to be exposed. The actual physical appearance may matter to you, so you have to take that into account as well. Well, I hope you found this useful. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to post those in the comment trail down below. I'm Chris with Toolbox DIY. Thanks for watching.